In the world of sports, the lines between competition and controversy have blurred. Welcome to the realm of sportswashing, where the beautiful game meets the murky waters of politics and PR. From Cristiano Ronaldo's surprising move to Al Nassr, to Mbappe's jaw-dropping billion-dollar deal. The most recent example of this has been LIV Golf, a flashy new venture backed by Saudi Arabia, aiming to disrupt the world of golf. Its arrival sent shockwaves through the sport, raising questions about ethics and morality. But then, something unexpected happened. LIV Golf and the PGA, two giants in the golfing world, decided to join forces. Joseph Nye's theory of soft power suggests that a nation's influence in global affairs is not solely determined by its military or economic might, but also by its ability to attract and persuade others through culture, ideology, and values. Soft power relies on attraction rather than coercion, shaping preferences and behavior through diplomatic, cultural, and informational means. It emphasizes the importance of narratives, values, and institutions in shaping international relations, alongside traditional hard power elements like military force and economic leverage. Sports washing is a term used to describe the practice of using sports events or investments in sports clubs or franchises to improve a country's reputation, particularly when it's involved in controversy or criticism for human rights abuses, authoritarianism, or other negative actions. Essentially, it's a form of image laundering, where the positive association with sports is used to distract from or mitigate negative perceptions of a country or organization. Now let's zoom in on the high-stakes world of golf, where Saudi Arabia's ambitions collided with the sport's integrity. Enter LIV Golf, a lavish new series backed by Saudi wealth, aiming to revolutionize the game. But behind the glitz lies a darker truth. Saudi Arabia, fueled by its oil riches, has sought to reshape its global image. But as scrutiny over its human rights abuses and suppression of minority rights intensified, the kingdom turned to sports as a distraction. Saudi Arabia has remained a dictatorial regime since its independence in 1927, with no room for freedom of thought, political dissent, and women's or any minority rights. Advocates for change are often met with harsh punishments, imprisonment, or even execution and death. An eerie example of this was the assassination of the anti-regime Saudi journalist Jamal Khashoggi in 2018. Over the past few years, there have been many developments in the global sporting world, where Saudi Arabia is either taking over different clubs or financially contributing towards hosting sporting events. One of the main factors why athletes are willing to go to Saudi Arabia is the lucrative salaries that the Saudis are willing to offer. LIV Golf is just the most recent example of this. The series got started in 2021 with notable golfers like Dustin Johnson, Phil Mickelson, and Brooks Koepka joining their fold. Again, significant paychecks were probably a big factor. LIV Golf's eye-watering offers to golfing legends like Tiger Woods and Jon Rahm, $600 million and $300 million respectively, served as bait, luring in top talent with staggering sums of money. LIV Golf debuted in London in 2022, and the winner of that event was guaranteed a prize of $4 million, which is far more anyone can expect to earn on the PGA Tour. Even the final finisher was promised $120,000. All in all, the Saudis have invested $255 million into the opening events of the new golfing franchise. The tour and the golfers were naturally faced with backlash, since LIV Golf was considered a ruse from the country's issues with political repressions and human rights violations.
I don't believe it should be controversial. As Lee touched on, you know, there's 8 events this year, 10 next year, 14 the year after. You know, there is plenty of room to be able to have other great tournaments on other great tours that we would like to compete in as well. So the legacy standpoint is I'm trying to provide for my family, which is the first and foremost thing that I want to do. You know, I come to work to play golf, and that is my job at the end of the day. I love it. I love playing golf. I love what the opportunity of LIV gives us from a standpoint of playing slightly less golf, which gives me the ability to be able to be fresher, ready to go. It's a magnificent opportunity that, you know, I'm really looking forward to.
Think about the fucking the LIV Golf thing.
Love it. Dude. Absolutely love it. Why not?
No, tell me more.
Here's the reason. And I told you before this, I know a guy that went over there. And here's the thing. some people love the preservation and the history of the PGA. I get it, tradition. A lot of things about the PGA are bullshit, and particularly the idea that the PGA had a stronghold on them.
Yet, just when the narrative seemed set, a seismic shift occurred. The unexpected merger between LIV Golf and the PGA rocked the golfing landscape, reshaping alliances and power dynamics.
Well, 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 Jason McIntyre. The PGA Tour lecturing their golfers about morals and values has now officially merged with the Saudi Arabian-backed LIV Tour.
The initial response from the PGA, which involved excluding LIV Golf participants from its tournaments, highlighted the moral conflicts that come with these partnerships. Although the merger hasn't yet been finalized, this unprecedented has already sent shockwaves through the industry, prompting reflection on the intersection of sports, money, and morality. If this action goes through, it would bring together the resources of both tours under Saudi control, leading to questions about how professional golf will be managed and maintained in the future. All in all, this shows that money talks and Saudi Arabian soft power efforts are paying off. PGA, at first the main critic of the LIV Golf series, has all but caved in and is now willing to accept the Saudi money that it first so heavily criticized. Saudi Arabia's support for the golf tour goes beyond just promoting the sport or encouraging cultural exchange. It is a strategic move to boost the country's soft power and global influence.